All right, let's get you some of those answers. So first we have our self-starters. That is our Gen Xers. So like we talked about, they were that really independent generation, right? They had to come home from school, they had to take care of themselves. So as a result, we see them being very much self-starters in the workplace as well. So that's kind of that characteristic and then how we see it play out in the workplace. Responsibility shared is our millennial generation. So because they were raised to be such a collaborative group, both in school and in extracurricular activities, we often see them have a very much of a team mentality when it comes to the workplace. So if one person succeeded, the whole team succeeded. Or if one person failed, the whole team failed. With our likes consensus, that is our baby boomers, they like to make sure that everybody has been heard, that everybody has had a seat at the table before they come to a conclusion or before they make a decision. Likes lots of information, similar also our baby boomers to that liking consensus piece. They want to make sure they've heard from as many people and all the right people before they come to that decision. So they like a lot of information to make those decisions. Teams and peer input, important. That is our millennial group. So again, they were that very much collaborative generation. All throughout school, I was expected to work in groups, whether that be actually in the classroom, during sports, during other extracurriculars. We were raised as that very collaborative generation. And so that teams piece, we very much value that in the workplace as well. Skeptical. That is our Gen Xers as well. So they were raised during the Nixon administration, right? They saw the Watergate scandal play out. And so because of that, they learned to be very skeptical at a young age and to question authority at a young age as well. Competitive is our boomers. So like I said earlier, there was 80 million of them in the workplace. That's huge, huge numbers. So they kind of had to fight each other out for things like for positions in the workplace and things like that. So they were a very competitive generation. Family first or cocooning is our Gen Xers. So not to say that other generations don't care about their families or don't care about that work-life balance, but our Gen Xers were really the first ones to kind of start pushing back against not having a work-life balance. I'm sure you guys have seen the E.T. movie. There's that scene where the mom has to go to work, but her kid is sick, so she hands him a can of Sprite and says, "Call me if you throw up," right? So that was kind of how it was before our Gen Xers. Baby boomers, especially the women in the baby boom generation, felt like they were playing catch up in the workplace. So they didn't have as much of an option to have that family work-life balance. So with our Gen Xers, they started to push back and say, no, we can have both. So they're looking for that work-life balance. And finally, scheduled childhood is our millennials. So similarly to how they were that collaborative generation, they also had a very scheduled childhood within that. So they were taught to check in after everything, right? So you go to swim practice, you check in. You go to a friend's house, you check in. And because of the invention of cell phones with our millennial generation, that was easy to do. You were able to check in with your parents after every step. So oftentimes now we're seeing that turn into a little bit of a hiccup in the workplace because our millennials are looking for feedback and our Gen Xers are that super independent generation. So we see some of that bumps there, right? So our millennials, they go and do A, they do a great job, they come back and say, okay, what's next? And our Gen Xers are going, well, why didn't you just do B, C, and D? I know you know how to do them. And that's because our millennials were taught to check in after every step of the way. So now we're seeing that in the workplace too. So they may know what the next steps are, but they want to check with you first and make sure that they haven't screwed anything up before they move forward in the process. All right, so those are some of our general characteristics with our generations. Now we're going to look at some of those bumps that we see in the workplace that play out because of these characteristics.